Hi, welcome back to Hostbox CHC channel. I'm back to Computer Architecture and Organization series. The series exclusive for whoever preparing GATE, UGC, NET and etc. Competitive exams and some university exams also. Let's go for session today. That is called instruction set. Have idea about instruction set and introduction to instruction format. So in the previous session, I explained about the program control instructions, where you know type of instructions having data transfer, data manipulation, at last followed by program control instructions. So this is one of the biggest area based on computer organization. I just highlighting and some points, what are points important here, and what way you understand. Let's go for example. You know the computer always perform the task based on the instructions given by the CPU, where you know CPU consists of ALU and control unit and so on. Before seeing this one, let's go for the example here. Let's assume the small program called C program called addition of two numbers. So here, how do you do in C programming? Main open brace, int a comma b, c is code a plus b and so on, print c and so on. So here, what a comma b means, these are data, and also we are giving instruction, that is c is code a plus b, that means adding. So add the value of a and b. For example, we give value for a is 10 and b value is 10, total it print 20, like somewhere stored in the computer. So similar to C programming, in the computers also, when you do something in the behind of the computers, there will be a place where all the information is stored. So we need already now control unit and register. We discuss about the registers, program counter, everything, and moreover instruction register is very, very important. So when I want to perform any operation with computer, it generally follow the instruction format. Here the bits of the instructions are divided into groups called field, and also the most common field found in the instruction format are, first one is called operation code, and the field that specify the operation to be performed, and also followed by address code, address field that designates a memory address or a processor register. At last, a mode field that specifies the way the operand or the effective address is determined. So let's have the example of instruction format. So instruction format generally having like this, for the mode, first up is in the mode and next one the opcode and another one is operand. For example, it is add 2 plus 2. Here opcode is called add, that means what kind of operation we are going to perform. The CPU has to understand and follow it. Then MUL means multiplication, meaning of that is called perform the multiplication operation. Here operands, I can give 2 plus 2 means what, with the operations, what kind of operation would perform. So if I give add 2 plus 2 means what, it try to print the answer of 4 and somewhere store. Remember here the instruction register will be there, from the memory location it go and fetch the data. So computer means, again and repeating, what is the three things are important? Fetching, decoding and executing. Fetch, decode, execute, these are the three task when you go for the computers. So lot of things happening behind the computers. Let's try to understand some of the point here. So instruction register will be there in the memory location, somewhere data will be there and go execute. Or you can say example add R1, R2, like that. And here what is mode? Here where there are lot of addressing modes supported by computers, like direct mode, indirect mode, register mode and so on. These registers I explain definitely in the upcoming class, upcoming sessions, like that. And moreover, how computers manage, and also the computers may have instructions of several different lengths containing varying number of addresses. Remember, there will be limitation for this instruction format here. Opcode, operand, some 8-bit, 12-bit and so on is there. And moreover, the number of address field in the instruction format of a computer depends on the internal organization of its registers. Most computers fall into one of the three of CPU reorganization. So what kind of CPU organization you want to choose, and based on that you can perform the task. One is called single accumulator organization, another one called general register organization, and another one is stack organization. The single accumulator organization, upcoming session we go to see. And remember, single organization means we need support of only one. And moreover, the instruction format divided into four categories generally. Zero address instruction, firstly one address instruction, two address instruction, three address instruction and so on. Here the first part I told you, single accumulator. So single accumulator organization generally follow like this only. There will be operand, only one operand. If you go other types, it take two operands here. Upcoming session we go and discuss. So just understand instruction format means there is a rectangular format where followed by the field called M mode. First one represents the mode, whether it's for example you add R1 comma directly adding, and opcode followed by opcode and followed by operand. So here, what is the use of opcode and I hope that you understand what is the subcode and operand and so on. So upcoming session we'll see the types of instruction formats as well as the single accumulator organization and so on. I hope that you understand. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe, comment in the host box here channel and stay tuned with social media. Thank you.